shall say, thank you for worshiping us this day, to bring our glory and honor to God, who has given us another chance to be alive and land of living. Together, praise his holy name in one accord. We ambassadors for the kingdom welcome all of his gifts, and take our praise in the presence of our King. We salute each of you. Ambassadors for the kingdom is on a mission with their vision, to prove God's agape love, bring forth the manifestation into action. In building and living the kingdom lifestyle, connecting kingdom servants to support the kingdom of God. As we continue to serve in the spirit and in truth, as we all walk, talk, and live and love this earth as one of the kings and queens, possessing our territory and the kingdom authority that comes from the Holy Spirit. Our prayers will be faithful, humble, teachable, obedient, as stewards of gifts and talents to build the kingdom of God. Now it's time for our church announcements. On Tuesdays at 6:30 p.m., tune in on Glory Broadcast Radio Station. You can download it on your smartphone. Walking in your kingdom authority with our senior pastor, the Sheriff Me. On Thursday nights at 8 p.m., join us on the Kingdom Prayer Call with our Apostle Ken Douglas and the entire team at 605-468-8002. Access code 105-6985. On Fridays at 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. on Eternal Light TV, tune in to King Word from the Throne of God. On Sundays, we are back at the Cathedral for the gathering of the Disciples of Jesus at 11 a.m. to worship, praise, hear word from God, and to show the agape love to one another. Doors open at 10:30 a.m. sharp as we prepare for a mighty meal of God together. We will sincerely thank each of you for your love, faithfulness, and work for the kingdom of God. We love each of you with the agape love and may God bless everything you touch and every soul you bring for his name's sake. Thank you and God bless you. One love, one God, one son. Thank you.
Everyone, please stand for the reading of God's word. I'll be reading from Psalms chapter 86, verse 1 to 6. Please say amen when you find it.
Amen.
Amen. Bow down thine ear, O Lord. Hear me, for I am poor and needy. Preserve my soul, for I am holy. O thou my God, serve thy servant that trusted in thee. Be merciful unto me, O Lord, for I cry unto thee daily. Rejoice, the soul of thy servant, for unto thee, O Lord, do I lift up my soul. For thou, Lord, art good and ready to forgive, and plenteous in mercy unto all of them that call upon thee. Give thine ear, O Lord, unto my prayer, and attend to the voice of my supplication. Amen.
Good morning, brothers and sisters.
Good morning.
In Christ, what a beautiful morning it is. Reach out and touch somebody and tell them you love them. Tell them hello, good morning. Tell them you're beautiful. God looks good on you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. As we get prepared to tithe and offering, I can't stress it enough how important it is to tithes and offerings. Stress it enough. Tithes and offerings. Tithes and ten. God say just a ten. If you made $100, then you get $10. If you made $500, then you get $50. Sow a seed and watch it grow. He sends us out into the field, sow a seed, and watch it manifest. Tithes and offering. very important to the body of Christ. That's what keeps the lights running. That's what keeps the doors open. That's what keeps us traveling to the four corners of the earth to touch lives, to bring them into the kingdom of heaven, to increase the body of Christ. Tithes and offering is important. Very important. You know, Jesus gathered around his disciples, and as he sat opposite in the place where the offering was put, I'm reading from Mark 12, 41, 44. And he watched the crowd putting their money into the temple treasury. Many rich folks brought plenty of things. Many wealthy folks gave plenty, plenty. But a poor widow came and put two very small copper coins. Copper coins mean penny. 2 cents. And Jesus called on his disciples and told them to come to me. And Jesus said, truly, I tell you, this poor widow who gave two copper coins out of all the wealthy, all the riches that you could ever bring, she put two copper coins into the treasury. They all gave out of their wealth, he said. But she, even out of poverty, even when you're down and out, she gave from her heart. Everything, all she had, and put it in for tithes. Jesus says she's the one that is truly, truly blessed. It's tithes and offering time.
You will be made rich in every way so that you can be generous on every occasion. And through us, your generosity will result in thanksgiving to God.
Amen.
Lord Father, we come to you to ask that you bless these tithes, that they may continue your work, Lord Father, that they help us get the strength to let no demon bounce us, Lord Father. And we provoke them, Lord Father, we provoke them, Lord Father, so they won't bother us. Amen.
Amen. Amen.